It's always wonderful to come back to the lively Hungaro Ring, a popular destination this, nice and close to the beautiful city of Budapest, with some exciting racing to boot. Who can forget Michael Schumacher pushing his old teammate Rubens Barrichello up towards the pit wall in 2010, or those great races of 2014 and 2015 as well. We're northeast of Budapest for the race today at the 2.7-mile Hungaro Ring circuit. 14 corners here, 8 to the right and 6 to the left, on a track where downforce is king and passing is notoriously difficult. With me today, of course, is Anthony Davidson. Let's talk briefly about Sebastian Vettel. That was a great win in the last race. Can they keep that momentum going this weekend?
It's always nice to come into a Grand Prix weekend on a high, but your expectations are based much more on your practice and qualifying runs. So it's the momentum from those sessions that they'll be hoping to carry into the race today.
We're almost ready to go then, and this is what the starting grid looks like for today's race. Kimi Raikkonen's perfect lap yesterday sees him start from pole position, with Daniel Ricciardo slotting in alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Vettel, Alonso, Lewis Hamilton, and Perez, Verstappen, Hülkenberg, Bottas, and Kevin Magnussen, Grosjean, Ocon, Charles Leclerc, and Sainz, and McLaren, Ericsson, Pierre Gasly, and Brendan Hartley. Sirotkin and Lance Stroll rounds off the grid. Now it's almost time to lights out, so let's go down to the track. Thank you.
softs. Trailing our teammate by 6.3 seconds. Some information on Verstappen. They're slowing down. It seems like there's some kind of problem with their car. Virtual safety car, virtual safety. Slow down. Your delta is negative, which means you are too fast. Reduce your pace. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. Got that confirmed. This lap, keep an eye on your distance to the speed limit line as you approach, and make sure you don't speed. VSC ending, we're going green. Maintain positive delta until the green flags. Look after these tyres now. We want to finish the race on this compound. Flag. is 5.4 seconds. The gap behind us is 2.5 seconds. Has come in and fitted the soft tire. Fuel target is plus one. Faster engine modes are available. Is 5.4 seconds. Let me know you're okay. You've been awarded. seconds. Okay, good work. Great pass. Front is 9.3 seconds. Okay, gap to leader, 17.8 seconds. Gap to the car ahead is 15.0 seconds. is 25.3 seconds. Seconds. We're at plus one lap of extra fuel. Fuel target plus one. Laps of fuel remaining. Okay, gap ahead is 23.2 seconds. Thank you. there's only one lap of fuel remaining. This is your final lap of the race. The end of the race. We'll see you in Parc Fermé.
Here's our winner pulling their Ferrari into Parc Fermé. What a fantastic race it was. And Anthony Davidson, give me your thoughts. How did they accomplish this result?
I think a large part of the result comes down to temperament. They were able to keep their heads when everyone around them was losing theirs. And that's allowed them to get the best out of the car, to maximize the strategy, and to stay out of trouble.
So, here they come now, out onto the podium. Wherever you go, anywhere in the world, the Prancing Horse flags are dominant in the grandstands, and they're out in force again today. It's Ferrari, on the top step once more. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. It's a good result for Kimi Raikkonen, who extends his advantage at the top of the championship. And now I'd like to ask you, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
Today I'm going to give it to the McLaren driver. They pushed and pushed and found some fantastic performance. It was just a pleasure to watch.
And now let's take a look at the constructors' standings. Ferrari extend their lead at the top of the championship. There was also a strong showing from the Mercedes team today as they make their way up the standings. Well, what a weekend that has been. Please join us next time for another thrilling installment of this Formula One season.
Good day today. Tell us about it from your perspective. You had a bit of a rivalry going on, but it looks like he bested you.
To auto bylo lepší. A kurva.
Do you have any comments about the collisions?
Nemám komentáře, bohužel jsem nasadil prací, ale...
Well, thanks anyway.
A aby to ještě nebylo málo, nastane nový kontrakt. Tady. porazil, já porazil Sergeje Sirotkina, takže velký přísun bodů. Je taky splnit týmový cíl za druhé místo během velké ceny Německa. 1266 vývojových bodů.
That's a great result. You did really well. I don't think we can have any complaints with.
It's time for us to renegotiate your contract. Here you can see the current deal. Once negotiations begin, the team will make you an offer. You can accept if you like, but I strongly suggest we push for better terms.